Hello everyone, this is Chaitra from Kumarjyoti Science and Commerce BU College, Shikaripura. So today, we shall discuss about a new chapter, Microbes in Human Welfare. Okay, so before going to discuss about the concept, we need to know about some basic concept about microbes. What are these microbes and where the microbes will be formed, that will be known. Okay, so here microbes. These microbes are the minute microscopic organisms, and microbes are bacteria, fungi, protozoans, viruses and the prions. These are collectively called as microbes, and these microbes will be found everywhere. So in the diversity, so we can say that these microbes are cosmopolitan in distribution. And they usually found in air, water and in our body. And these microbes usually have a peculiar characteristic feature. So that peculiar characteristic feature is they will be found even in the high temperature areas. For example, even in the 100 degrees Celsius temperature, these microbes will be found. And also deep inside the seas and inside the geysers, these microbes will be formed. These are some peculiar characteristic feature of the microbes. Okay. So now let's discuss about the concept in this chapter. Okay. So usually in this chapter we will be discuss about microbes in industrial products, microbes used as an household products, biocontrol agents and biofertilizers, and preparation of biogas, or commonly called as methane gas. Okay. So first concept is microbes used as an microbes used as an household product. Microbes in household product. Okay. So, usually majority of the peoples think that microbes are causing a hazardous diseases. They are very dangerous. But majority of the microbes are useful, or they play a very vital role in a human welfare. And only some of the microbes, such they will be causing diseases such as plague and diphtheria, leprosy, etc. But majority of them will be very beneficial to the human kind. Okay. So here, microbes in household product. So for example, a bacteria which is called as lab bacteria, that is lab. This lab is abbreviated as lactic acid bacteria. Okay, so this lactic acid bacteria is useful in the conversion of milk into curd. So we know the procedure of the conversion of milk into curd. So in that process, this lactic acid bacteria play a major role. How it will be convert the milk into curd? So before that, the fresh milk which contains a lab bacteria, and this lab bacteria partially digest the milk protein, and also it increases the vitamin B12 and also improves the nutritional quality in the milk. Okay, by this way, the lactic acid bacteria or lab bacteria useful as a household product. Okay, Yes, like the lactic acid bacteria, there are other different types of lactic acid bacteria are there. They may be Lactobacillus lactis, Lactobacillus acidophilus. These are the different varieties of lactic acid bacteria. They also involved in the conversion of milk into curd. Okay, so the next one is, the next product is dough. So usually dough isn't used for the preparation of the food items such as idli, dosa, etc. Okay, so usually, so when we preparing the idli, dosa, so at that time the volume of the food will be increases, okay, or rice will be increases. So that will be due to the presence of the microbes in that dough. Okay, those microbial activity help us to increase the volume of the food. Okay, and next one is toddy. Okay, so toddy is a traditional drink. Okay, so usually this toddy is used in the southern India, and the sap, the fermented sap is extracted with the help of the microbes by the palm tree. Okay, so this toddy is a traditional drink which is extracted from the palm tree and the, in the southern parts of the India. Okay, and the one more food item that is called as cheese. This is an another product. Cheese is an another product. So here, cheese, there are different varieties of cheese are there. First one is Swiss cheese. And another one is cheese. There are two varieties of cheese are they? One it is Swiss cheese and another one it is Roquefort cheese. So here Swiss cheese is characterized by its flavor and its taste. Okay, and this Swiss cheese has a large amount of or large sizing of a holes. Swiss cheese has a large holes, and these large holes is present due to the releasing of large amount of an carbon dioxide, and this carbon dioxide is released due to the presence of the bacteria, so that is called as propionibacterium. Releasing of the carbon dioxide, and this releasing of the carbon dioxide is mainly due to the presence of the bacteria called as Propionibacterium germani. Okay, so this is a one of the product, household product. So next one is Roquefort cheese. So Roquefort cheese is also fermented with the help of the microbes only. Okay, so these are all the different types of household products. These are used in the house and by the help of the microorganisms. Okay, so now shall we move on to the next concept, that is microbes in industrial product. Thank you. microbes in industrial product. Okay, so usually there are plenty of microorganisms also used in the industries for the preparation of ethanol, nothing but alcohol, and also chemicals, enzymes, and the bioactive molecules. So now we shall discuss about one by one in detail. Okay, so first one is microbes used in the preparation of fermented beverages in the industries. Okay, so here for the preparation of wine, beer, brandy, whiskey, and the rum. Okay, so for the production of these, the microbes will be play a vital role. So usually here beer and the wine used in the preparation without distillation. Okay, but the other products such as rum and the brandy, so they will be prepared by the microbes with distillation. Okay, so these are the products prepared by the microbes. Okay, so next one is antibiotics. Okay, so next one is antibiotics. So as we already know about antibiotics, antibiotics are the chemical substances. These are the chemical substances prepared by the microorganism, and they also fight against the other microorganism, disease causing microorganism. So here anti, it is a Greek word in which anti means against. Anti means against and bio means life. So together it is called as against life. That means this antibiotics play a major role in killing the antigens or disease causing pathogens. Okay, so those are called as antibiotics, and these antibiotics are first proposed by or discovered by a great scientist called as Alexander Fleming. Alexander Alexander Next product is antibiotics. Here antibiotics are the chemical substances. They are prepared from the microorganism and they are against the pathogenic organisms. Here anti means, it is a Greek word which means against. Anti means against, and bio, bio means life. Here together it is called as against life. That means the antibiotics are fight against the pathogenic or disease causing organisms, and these antibiotics are first discovered by a great scientist called as Alexander Fleming. Alexander Fleming. Alexander Fleming was first discovered the antibiotic which was known as penicillin. Penicillin is the first antibiotic which was discovered by Alexander Fleming. Okay, and this antibiotic is used or which is used on the soldier, American soldier who is suffering from the who is suffering in Second World War. Okay, and Alexander Fleming discovered the penicillin while he working on the staphylococci bacteria. This is a staphylococci bacteria does not grow around which he washed the culture plate. Okay. And after his work, he named this penicillin as Penicillium notatum. He gave the name to the mold, that is Penicillium notatum. Okay. So this is about an antibiotics prepared by the microorganisms, usually in the industrial areas. Okay. So next one is chemicals, bioactive molecules and enzymes. Chemicals, enzymes and bioactive molecules. So for examples, in the industries, these microorganisms are used in the preparation of chemicals such as organic acids and the preparation of ethanol or alcohol. Okay. So for example, Aspergillus niger, the first example is Aspergillus niger. It is a type of fungi. Okay. And this fungi produces an acid called as citric acid. Aspergillus niger, a fungi which produces an acid called as a citric acid. Like that, Clostridium butylicum, it is a type of a bacterium which produces an acid called as butyric acid, So like that, one more bacterium, that is Acetobacter acetae, which produces an acid called as acetic acid, Okay. So these are the microbes or the fungi and the bacteria which produces the acid for the welfare of humankind in the industrial areas. Okay. Now we shall move on to the next, enzymes. So next one is enzymes. So some enzymes such as lipases. Lipases are an enzymes which are produced by the microorganism, and these lipases are used as an preparation of detergents to remove the oily stains from the laundry. Okay. And other enzymes are there from the microbes. Those may be bottle fruit juices such as masa, slice, etc. Okay. So usually bottle fruit juices which are brought from the marketplaces which are more clearer than the juice made at a home. This is due to the presence of or using of proteases and the pectinases enzymes. Okay, so those juices are more clearer. Okay, so next enzyme is streptokinase. Enzyme which is produced by Streptococcus bacteria. Okay, so this streptokinase enzyme used as a clot buster. Okay, streptokinase enzyme produced by the Streptococcus bacteria which used as a clot buster. So usually the patient who is undergone blood clotting diseases are myocardial infarction, commonly called as a heart attack. So in that patient, the blood will be clot in the blood vessels. So to remove the clot in the blood vessels, these clot busters such as streptokinase enzymes are used with the help of the microorganisms. Okay, so these are the some of the enzymes prepared by the microbes for the welfare of humankind in the industrial areas. So next, bioactive molecules. Yes. So next one is bioactive molecule. So there are some bioactive molecule such as cyclosporin A. So this is a type of bioactive molecule and which is act as an immunosuppressive agent. This cyclosporin A act as an immunosuppressive agent usually in the organ transplant patient. So as we know, the procedure nowadays, our technology is very advanced. So in this, they can transplant the organs to the patients from the healthier persons. Okay, so that is by the these bioactive molecules such as cyclosporin A act as an immunosuppressive agent. So like that, one more bioactive molecule is there, that is statin. So statin, which is extracted from the yeast, one more yeast. As we already know, the common yeast or brewer yeast, that is Saccharomyces cerevisiae. Okay, so but this statin, which is produced by or extracted by one more yeast, that is Monascus purpurea. Okay, so another one yeast is Monascus purpurea. So from this Monascus purpurea, a bioactive molecule will be formed, that is called as a statin, which helps in the lowering of blood cholesterol level. Okay, so these are all the products which are produced by the microorganism in the industrial areas. Okay, thank you.